Water polo. Do you know anything about water polo aside from the fact that it's played in water? I don't. And if you're anything like me, you'll also know next to nothing about sports aside from the ones they make major video games about, because if you're watching a video like this one, you probably don't go outside much. If you're thinking to yourself, wow, a water polo anime, that's a first, you'd apparently be wrong, because there are at least four other manga, one having an OVA adaptation, where water polo is at least somewhat important to the plot. But it would be accurate to say that this is the first major water polo anime made by a large studio that anybody is going to give a shit about. So what's it about? After watching the first episode, I wouldn't say water polo because nobody played it on screen even once yet. We see somebody appear to be drowning in some still images, but so far, even today, I don't know a goddamn thing about water polo because this cartoon hasn't taught me. To say that this is uncharacteristic for a sports-oriented anime is an understatement. In fact, every sports show I watched recently tossed us right into the fray, focusing on the sweaty ball-grabbing games as quickly as possible, sometimes even in the opening minutes. But you'd probably be right in assuming this is a safe move. I mean, the show's advertised with the sport, the title's based on one of the rules of the game, so I imagine the hook for the show would be how fucking sick the game is and how cool or low budget, depending on what we're working with here, it looks in its full animated glory. I'm sure MAPPA will do a good job of making the action shots look fine, but this aside, what does the first episode spend its time doing if not showing off the budget? Remain is about Minato Kiyomizu, a star water polo athlete just on the verge of high school, or at least he was until his mom almost killed the whole family in a car accident with a truck. And although Mom has simply avoided the genre switching to shit-fuck isekai, she inadvertently traumatized her daughter, had her husband dress as Mario, and sent Minato into a half-year coma, followed by the revelation that he remembers his life only up to the 6th grade, aka, forgot everything about water polo. So now he must decide how to carry on with all the lost facets of his life, including whether he should return to the sport he doesn't remember being good at least he doesn't remember now, not ever since the accident. All this to say, the first episode sets us up with this shocking, tragic character background, while also allowing us some insight into their lives. For instance, we find that Minato's family owns and operates a local clothing shop where a turtle acts as their signature mascot. Remain did something daring by failing to introduce extreme sports action right off the bat. Remain instead opted to give us time to stew alongside our main character because the show wants to give us more of a reason to care about this guy playing water polo. When the sport is the only focus, it's difficult to give a damn when a character comes out with some half-assed motivational speech about how it's their life goal suddenly to be the greatest water polo champion all of history. Hell, if a show isn't going to set aside time or even prioritize character development, you might as well just be watching a real match. You'd get about as much personality out of it. It's risky to show a preference for this to the point of not demonstrating the sport entirely, but I feel Remain has done so competently. Ultimately, for a show exclusively about characters playing sports to succeed, both sports and likable characters are necessary. It's possible the show will defy all expectation. Minato could panic about a math test he's 3 years late to study for, charge across the street, and get run over, waking up from a coma again, having lost his memory up from after the start of elementary school. I think we both know that that would be the most beneficial route. For now, I can understand why somebody would care to see why Minato bothers to continue playing water polo, but only time will tell if water polo can keep us wet and wanting more.